Hi all, I'm Monica, a content manager here at Oxylabs. Today, I will explain to you what browser fingerprinting is, how it works, and whether or not you should prevent your browser fingerprinting. Now, let's start with the definition of browser fingerprinting. Basically, it's a data collection method that hashes browser settings and builds a digital signature, also known as a digital fingerprint. Web browser fingerprint includes user agent, screen size and resolution, installed fonts, plugins, extensions, and more. All of the mentioned details aid in identifying a particular device. It's common for websites to add a JavaScript code in their HTML pages to gather the browser parameters for fingerprinting. Top-ranked websites and search engines, including Google and Bing, use browser fingerprinting to recognize new and returning users. There are several techniques to do this. First, audio context fingerprinting that tests how your device processes sound signals and gathers data about the audio stack, such as sound hardware, software, and drivers. Then we have HTML5 canvas. A more advanced browser fingerprinting version that can offer even more information, such as graphics processing capabilities. HTML5 Canvas helps to retrieve the operating system, browser, and GPU of your device. By asking the device to render images, the fingerprint is calculated from that image, as every device renders them differently. And finally, we have a clock skew, an extreme browser fingerprinting measure when electrical signals from one source come to different components unequally. As hardware temperature variations influence this, a proper data analysis might define hardware specifics and many other aspects of a device. Another concept worth noting in terms of fingerprinting is browser uniqueness. This is a crucial factor that determines whether a user can be identified or not. To put it simply, browser uniqueness compares user devices and searches for duplicates. If there are only a few copies of the same data, the device is said to be unique. Information collected due to browser fingerprinting, however, helps companies to collect your information and track you on the internet. If you wish to prevent such tracking, lowering browser uniqueness is the solution. You can do it actually in multiple ways. Choose a commonly used browser such as Chrome or Firefox. Avoid unique user agents, instead use common ones. Minimize the number of plugins installed. Specify the preferred language list or disable JavaScript. Ironically, some anti-fingerprinting solutions might result in the opposite, increasing your browser uniqueness. So there is no single answer on preventing fingerprinting. That's why we recommend experimenting with these options and browse with the most suitable combination. Know that many of the above options can break most websites. So to sum up, browser fingerprinting is a common way to track users. It is still possible to avoid it by decreasing browser uniqueness, yet the most efficient option is disabling JavaScript, even though it might actually impact how a website is displayed. I hope this video has helped you to better grasp what browser fingerprinting is and how it works. If you have any questions about browser fingerprinting or any other specific topic, drop us a line at hello@oxylabs.io or simply leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to press the like button and share it on social media if you like this content. Thanks for watching and see you in other videos!